Welcome to another Learn and Gain session on ITIL. In this video we will talk about information security management. It is a management activity within the corporate governance framework, which provides the strategic direction for security activities and ensures objectives are achieved. The purpose of ISM is to provide a focus for all aspects of IT security and manage all IT security activities. The term information is used as a general term, and includes data stores, databases and metadata. The objective of information security is to protect the interests of those relying on information, and the systems and communications that deliver the information, from harm resulting from failures of availability, confidentiality and integrity. What should be included in an ISM? ISM process should include the production, maintenance, distribution and enforcement of an information security policy, and supporting security policies. Understanding the agreed, current and future security requirements of the business, and the existing business security policy and plans. Implementation of a set of security controls that support the information security policy, and manage risks associated with access to services, information and systems. Documentation of all security controls, together with the operation and maintenance of the controls, and their associated risks. Management of suppliers and contracts, regarding access to systems and services, in conjunction with supplier management. Management of all security breaches and incidents associated with all systems and services. The framework or the ISMS, in turn provides a basis for the development of a cost-effective information security program that supports the business objectives. The frameworks to design, implement, manage, maintain and enforce information security processes and controls, systematically and consistently throughout the organizations. Objective is to establish a management framework to initiate and manage information security in the organization. Allocate responsibilities, establish and control documentation. The objective of the plan element of the ISMS is to devise and recommend the appropriate security measures based on an understanding of the requirements of the organization. The objective of the implementation of the ISMS is to ensure that appropriate procedures, tools, and controls are in place to underpin the information security policy. Evaluation is to supervise and check compliance with security policy and security requirements. Perform audits of technical security of IT systems, provide information to auditor. Maintain objective is to improve security agreements, implementation of security measures and controls, and so on. This should be achieved using a PDCA cycle, which is a formal approach suggested by ISO 27001 for the establishment of the information security management system. Information security is not a step in life cycle of services. It needs to be an integral part of all services, and is an ongoing process that needs to be monitored continuously. Security measures can be used at a specific stage in the prevention and handling of security incidents, as illustrated. Let us take a look at the various security controls with some examples. Allowing authenticated users to access information on a server, preventing from everyone to access the information on a server. Enabling access control on servers is preventive. Taking backup of your information on a regular basis to prevent loss of information due to some unforeseen incident. Even if data is lost, most of it can be recovered. It is always important to discover the threat as soon as possible. Enabling monitoring to detect threats, antivirus software monitoring virus alerts are examples. A counteractive measure for repeat incidents. An example could be an account getting locked after incorrect password attempts, debit card blocked after entering incorrect PIN. It is performing the corrective measures to repair the damage. An example could be restoring the data from backup once lost. Fallback or rollback are also other examples. Hope we have provided you with a brief understanding on information security management. For more videos, please visit our website www.learnandgain.in. You can also subscribe to our channel on YouTube. We will be publishing more videos on ITIL. You can also follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/learnandgain. You can also follow us on LinkedIn. You can also follow us on Twitter. Thank you and have a nice day.